I go, yeah, we just so happen to be undefeated. I'm sure that this year is going to be hell. As if it were that easy. I went with Team Zero, and I went 3 times. It was easier planning, but the tricks got more insane as the years went on. We were really worried about Flip when Flip was on. It turns out that they were like, fuck it. Fakie kickflip manual, fakie 3 flip out. We couldn't find a good manual pad. It took a long time. Casper slide took like 3 hours of 3 dudes trying it. Dude, fakie heel flip over spine. Ended up not being nearly as difficult as it was intimidating after it got figured out, but looking at it on the list and not being at a spine was just horrible. Winning. Winning. Numerous meltdowns. It felt like the whole world was on your shoulders because you would try fakie heel flip over a spine and you would, you know, be trying that forever, and then it felt like you went straight from that straight into something else, and you felt like everything was on your shoulders, and that's how everybody felt because everybody was doing stuff. Ultimate King of the Road Skater would have to be Costin, right? He'd be the dude, right? Able to skate tranny, able to skate vert, able to skate a pool, able to skate a wedge, a big handrail. So yeah, it has to be Costin. I have a nice little display. They're top tier on the bookshelf. Nah, probably not. I got nothing to prove. Plus, it would mess up the whole symmetry of my shelf. It looks really good right now. I don't want to mess it up. If I had to just fire out a name right now, I'd go Nike. Only because Costin has experience. Costin, like I said, is best King of the Road skater. And it really depends on who wants to live in hell. Because he can deal with that much pain for 2 weeks in a row. If you have Costin and Jamie together, that's probably the unbeatable team. You never get used to seeing Tommy naked. It's just, it's awful. Stay hungry. Think D. Snyder, big bone in the hand. You know, because it doesn't end. Just live in the torture. That's all you can do.